Picture this. You're at your favorite coffee shop. The smell of fresh coffee surrounds you. It's comforting, familiar. You step up to that counter, ready to order that perfect soy latte, the one thing that will help you get through the rest of the day. You know exactly what you want, but this time, when you open your mouth, nothing comes out. You try again, still silence. The barista is waiting. The line behind you is getting longer. You can feel the pressure, the stares. You're trapped in this silence, desperate to be understood, but no one can hear you. Now imagine this isn't just about ordering coffee. For many non-speaking children, this struggle follows them everywhere. It's in a classroom where they cannot raise their hand to ask for help with a difficult question. It's in a playground where they can't call out to their friend to join in their game. It's in a doctor's office where they cannot describe the pain that they're feeling, or during an emergency where they cannot call out for help even when every second counts. Think about how often you use your voice without even realizing it. To tell someone you're sick, to ask for directions in an unfamiliar place, to tell someone you love them, or to say stop when something doesn't feel right. For these children, communication is more than just thoughts. It's about safety, it's about connection, it is about survival. That's where I come in as a pediatric speech pathologist, someone who can see the invisible threads of communication where others might only see silence. I have the privilege of working with some remarkable young children, primarily those who are non-speaking. They may be non-speaking either because they are autistic, have cerebral palsy, or other physical and cognitive conditions. These children have dreams, thoughts, and feelings, but words are not typically the way they are able to express them. Complex communication needs simple solutions. As a specialist in augmentative and alternative communication, or as I like to call it, anytime, anyhow communication, or AAC, my work revolves around assessing and providing these children with the right tools to communicate besides talking. It is about helping people express themselves in whatever way feels comfortable for them, whether that's through sign language, picture boards, gestures, or a device where they tap on a picture and it says it out loud for them. Think of AAC as a new language to use when words aren't available. And perhaps one of the most exciting, groundbreaking, and transformative discoveries is the rise of artificial intelligence. AI is currently pushing the boundaries of what we thought was possible for communication. It offers this undeniable potential for non-speaking children, leading us to a future where their individual voices can be heard in ways we never even imagined. Understanding emotions is the first step in helping non-speaking children communicate. For these children, expressing emotions is an ongoing challenge. If we as humans often fail to understand their emotions, how can technology possibly bridge this gap? Emotion AI is starting to address this challenge. It is a type of artificial intelligence that can identify human emotions by measuring changes in your facial expressions, body language, and heart rate. By analyzing key movements of your eyes and your mouth, it can identify emotions like joy, fear, and sadness. Currently, emotion AI uses facial recognition systems to identify the changes in these features and classify emotions based on what it has learned. For non-speaking children, this could be a breakthrough. It can give them so much more control over their emotional experiences and allow them to express their needs, desires, and fears with so much more clarity. As a researcher in lexical semantics, I've studied how our brains organize language and how neurons compete and collaborate to find the right words. The same process shapes our emotions connecting language and feelings in ways we often overlook. The aim of my study is to use the unique emotional experiences of these non-speaking children, and then hopefully that can be used to train AI neural networks. The foundation of this future is being built today. I imagine a world where emotion AI is accessible everywhere, potentially through wearables. Allowing children to navigate their social world, feel deeply validated in their emotions, and experience this profound sense of safety, knowing that their emotions will always be recognized and respected in real time. But understanding emotions is just one part of the AI puzzle. The next step is in helping non-speaking children to use AI, which can then help them to communicate with speech in a way that they can. Arlo is a six-year-old boy with Marfan syndrome, which means the tissues that hold his body together are weaker than usual, making activities like movement and coordination extremely challenging for him. He also has a severe speech disorder and a stutter, which means speaking can take him up to 4 times longer than children his age. Some sounds are repeated up to 10 times before he can finally move on, making it so exhausting that he sometimes becomes non-speaking when life gets too overwhelming for him. Arlo is the kind of child who lights up every room he walks into. At school, he's adored by his teachers and friends for his endless curiosity and infectious enthusiasm. He wants you to learn about Pokemon and Spider-Man, get all the details right. But he isn't always understood. Every word he speaks shows you just how much he longs to connect, and you can't help but be captivated by his spirit. While exploring ways to support children like Arlo, I found VoiceIt, a communication software designed to understand and translate the speech of people with communication difficulties. VoiceIt uses machine learning to understand how the child speaks. It listens to the unique sounds, tone, and rhythm of the child's speech, and over time, it gets better at recognizing their voice. Once it has learned these patterns, it can then change these unique sounds into clear words that anyone can understand. Let's have a quick look at how this worked for Arlo. Instead of struggling to be understood, he can now ask for his favorite toy, share his weekend adventures, or tell you what excites him about Pokemon. This technology gives him the power to communicate and connect with everyone around him. His voice is now clear to everyone, no matter how he speaks. It's about giving him that chance to connect, be heard, and take part in conversations that matter the most to him. The next breakthrough in AI is its ability to understand non-spoken language. When words aren't even available, even the smallest movement holds incredible power to communicate. For Mia, a 10-year-old with Rett syndrome, this is her reality. Unable to control most of her body, Mia relies on tiny gestures like a head tilt or a blink to connect with the rest of the world. Imagine trying to express every need, every thought, every feeling you have using just that. Fortunately, software like Vocable AAC transforms this experience. Using advanced software to track Mia's head movements, it detects where her gaze is focused on the screen. By holding her gaze on a specific phrase, Mia can select it, triggering the app to then speak that chosen message out aloud. This allows her to navigate quickly and communicate through phrases that may be personalized for her. Here I am showing you how Vocable AAC works.
Please open the window. I would like to talk. Please close the window.
The AI in Vocable AAC does much more than offer her simple phrases. It understands from the way she communicates. and offers her responses that she might want to use next. It also remembers everything around her, like listening to everyone communicating around her, picks responses that might fit the conversation naturally, and makes it easier for Mia to express herself with less effort. With just a few head movements, Mia can narrate an entire story. Imagine the power of being able to express everything on your mind using only the tilt of your head. She can now pick her favorite show, complete her assignments, message her friends, whether she's picking out clothes online or scheduling a next appointment or staying more involved in her family plans. Mia now has the power to make choices that shape her life. She is no longer defined by her limitations, but by her voice, a voice that AI has helped unlock. For far too long, children who communicate differently have been unfairly viewed as less capable than their peers. This misunderstanding has led through a lot of these children going through life without ever being truly understood. Today, we change that. Artificial intelligence offers this groundbreaking opportunity to transform the lives of non-speaking children by providing tools that make communication not only accessible, but also deeply personal and intuitive. With AI, a child who has never spoken before could finally tell you when something isn't right, connect deeply with their loved ones, or express emotions that they've been holding inside for a long time. With AI, a child could finally express their needs, dreams, and thoughts without ever relying on someone else to guess what they need. We must rethink how we approach communication and AI. This intersection holds immense potential, but only if we challenge the way these systems are designed. Too often, AI is designed with the assumption that the user can already speak, read, or write fluently. We must expand on that vision to create AI that serves everyone, no matter how we communicate, right? Because every child deserves not just to be heard, but to be understood. And it's time we listen. Thank you.